wait on you. Everybody's moving, everyone is going somewhere. With everything they're trying just to make it to a place where I am not there.
So we're going to do our Bible reading for the night. Gabby, can you help us? So, Psalm 23.
Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green.
Good. Okay. So, Debbie, just pray for us so that we can go to bed.
Thank you, Lord, for everything.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord, for all that I've done.
Thank you, Jesus.
God, we pray that
Mom
will get
the
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay, girls, time to go to bed.
All right. God bless you.
Good night. Make sure you go and sleep.
Okay. Gabby, I don't want any Gabby, noise. What do you have to do?
Sleep. Sleep. See you tomorrow. Right. Love you. Bye. Bye. Oh, not again. Another rejection mail. I was hopeful about this job and was even qualified for the role. Oh my God, what is wrong? This is the 47th unsuccessful mail I'm receiving. Ah, am I that bad? Am I that dull?
No, not yet, not yet. I'm so sorry, dear. I really want you to be encouraged. Your job will come at its own right time. Let's keep trusting God.
Trust? I'm tired of trusting God. When will he answer? When will my testimony come? God, when and why? Why is this happening to me?
We can only trust God. We can only rely on him. Let's keep trusting him. Let's pray. And I believe the right time will come.
Amen.
All right, then? Yes. Let's pray. Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for our lives. We thank you where you're taking us to, God.
Wait on you. Everybody's moving.
No! Please leave my luggage for me.
What's wrong?
I had an unfamiliar dream. I seem not to understand.
A familiar dream? Tell me about it. What's wrong?
Yes, in the dream, I was carrying my luggage and a car parked close to me and an elderly man offered to give me a ride to relieve me of my stress. And I seemed happy and relieved. Yes, the strange thing to me was that I was sitting down in the vehicle, but I was still carrying my luggage on my head.
That is very strange.
Yes, that's not even the worst part of it.
I think God is trying to pass a message here to us. Tell me more. What happened?
The driver politely asked that I put the luggage in the trunk so that I would be more comfortable. But I insisted that I wanted to carry this luggage. He persuaded with me, but I still listen.
Jesus Christ, this is very strange. I mean,
what could
you
mean?
Why would you be carrying your own luggage in your head when a car has a trunk?
Ah, my dear, I don't know. I think this is, it's very strange.
Strange indeed.
Should think about this.
I think there's a message God is trying to pass to us here. So that we need to commit it to God's hand. Yeah. Let us pray. We need to pray about this. Oh. Heavenly Father,
yes, Lord.
We thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you for your love.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we are prayed.
That I am God.
Ah. Pastor, welcome.
Yeah,
sir.
Sister Rachel.
Thank you very much for visiting.
Thank you for having me in your beautiful home. And how is Brother David, your husband?
He's fine, sir. He went to the office. He should be back anytime from now,
oh,
sir.
Oh, that's great. That's
thank
great.
You very much, sir.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ah.
Oh, yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
How was work?
Fine.
Let's see who we have here.
Oh, Pastor Matt!
Hi, David.
I'm so happy to see you here today.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
I must
me.
Have won that's a Visa me. Lottery or something yeah. to have you around.
How's everything?
Thank you very much, sir. I'm doing well. How's it going, sir?
Good.
I was just telling Pastor Matthew that we've never had anyone visit us from the church before.
Oh, wow.
Yes, we haven't.
You mean no one has visited you guys since you landed in Canada?
Well, I mean, you know, everybody's busy, so I understand.
Oh, I apologize on behalf of the church. I think we need to do better. So no one has come in the last 14 months that you've been here. Maybe I have to speak to the pastorate and so we could find time to visit people that have come to our church under 2 years. Within the next 6 months.
I mean, honestly, Pastor, I think it's not a big problem. I mean, a lot of people have been so busy, so we understand. I think we're also guilty, right?
Yeah.
You know, since we came, we haven't had time to visit anyone.
Oh, so in that case, I think we all have to do better.
That would be wonderfully great, sir. Eshegon.
What?
Oh, sorry, Pastor. I mean, it means thank you so much.
Oh, okay, okay.
Right, so, Pastor Matthew said he had a message from God for us. So.
Oh, a message?
Yeah.
Oh, please, sir, go ahead.
Oh, yes. This morning, while I was praying, the Lord impressed it on my heart to come speak to you, to your family. And so I have to come personally to share this word with you. But first, I want you to read the book of... The book of Psalm chapter 37, verse 7, and also the book of Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6.
Okay. Psalm 37, verse 7. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret when people succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Pastor, you said Proverbs?
Yes, Proverbs 3, verse 5 to 6.
Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him and he will make your path straight.
Yeah. So I'm not so sure why this word is coming, but I'm very, very sure that when we trust, when we put things in God's hands, we should allow him to walk. We should not try to help him. Let's just trust in him and not be impatient.
Pastor Matt, you know, this is actually in line with the dream of late my wife has been having. And I think it's a message for us to really rely on God and wait patiently for him.
All right. So can we share a word of prayer before I leave?
Absolutely, sir.
Yeah. Our Father, our God, we thank you today. Father, we thank you for your word that you have come to share with us. And Lord, we pray that you give us the grace to trust in you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, give us the grace to always rely on you and not be impatient in every of our doings.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Lord, we pray that you help us, that we need help from above. And that help will come into our life in this family in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Hey, it's been 3 weeks since I had this interview. And I was told to send in my updated resume. I shared it already. Why is it taking the team so long to provide an update? Let me call Sandra. Maybe she would have an update. Hello, Sandra.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Rachel, I'm fine. No, how are you too?
I'm good. I'm just wondering if you would have an update of the role I applied within your department. It's 3 weeks and nothing.
Wow. Did you say 3 weeks? They should have provided you feedback by now. Except something is wrong. Wait. How many years of experience did you specify? when they asked you for an updated resume?
I stated 8 years, since that's what I have.
Oh no. You shouldn't do that. You should have stated 10 years. They will only give the job to those with at least 10 years of experience.
Ha! I didn't know that. Ha! And I've already submitted it. Because it's 8 years experience that I had. Ha! Does this mean I'll lose this job? Hey God, this is the best opportunity and closest I've come since my job set so far.
I'm sorry, Rachel. I think you missed this one. Except I tried to convince the HR that you have 10 years. Can you update the resume and resend?
But I don't have 10 years experience. Where will I get the additional 2 years?
Rachel. Rachel. This thing is not that hard now. Add 2 years and resend and you'll get the job offer. Or leave it as it is and you lose this great offer. Timing is of essence here. The ball is in your court. Heaven helps those who help themselves. Think about it and let me know.
Okay. I'll let you know. Thank you.
All right.
Hello?
Hello.
Oh, hello, Rachel. I hope you're doing fine.
Oh, hi, Emily. Yes, I'm good.
Yeah, so we were having some discussion and we were almost close to making a decision on the role. But there's just one thing we wanted to confirm with you, if that's all right.
Oh, yes. I even plan on reaching out to you because I actually have 10 years experience and I wanted to send you an updated resume.
Oh, are you able to confirm that you have 10 years? Because your resume currently shows 8 years.
Yes, I have 10 years experience.
Just to be sure, are you sure about that?
Yes.
Okay. Well, if you have 10 years, that's a change. And you can send me the updated resume and then we can work with that.
Okay, thank you. I'll send it after this call.
Okay, that will be all. We will get back to you before end of day tomorrow. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay, thank you. Oh, Lord. What have I done? Yay! Hey! What have I done? Hey, God. Why did I have to lie?
What's wrong?
Honey, you know the job I went for the interview?
Yes.
So, Sandra called. I called Sandra to ask her for updates and she advised that I put in 10 years as against the 8 years that I had. Because that was what they requested for. So I changed it and now I received the rejection mail and they actually explained why they rejected me because of they went to verify the job and I didn't have it. Oh God, why did I have to lie now?
Oh no, sweetheart.
God, why is this happening to me?
Why do you have to lie? That is not what we are called to do as children of God.
Will God forgive me? Now I'm battling two things, no job, and I've sinned against God.
Sweetheart, no matter what in life, we need to let God lead. We should always be patient because God's timing, as they say, is always the best.
Will God forgive me?
Our God is a merciful God. All we have to do is pray and ask Him for forgiveness. And I'm sure He's willing to give us a second chance always. But we should remember in life, as Christians, we should always wait for God's timing because His timing is always the best. I'm sorry, sweetheart. All we can do is to go to God in prayers. And I believe He's going to show you mercy and give you and us a second chance. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything.
Everyone is going somewhere. With everything they're trying, just to make it to a place where I am not.